Hi guys.
I just assembled a Prusa printer, a Prusa MKS 3 Plus. And after the calibration, which was rather straightforward, I'm printing now my first object. It's the Prusa logo. And it's looking really well. So nine minutes left. Assembly was very well explained in the handbook, with lots of pictures. And I spent 1 week, 2 hours a day, more or less. The timing is according to the things I specify in the handbook. It's rather impressive. I was very impressed with the build-up of this printer. That's the overall picture. It's quite high, as you can see, but it fits well on my bench. You need a solid bench, but that's most of the time no problem. If you follow the instruction, it's possible for everyone to assemble the printer. There is also an online assembly manual, and there you can read comments from other people. That's also very useful. Now it's actually printing in a PLA filament. That's the most common filament, but that one is not so heat resistive. So around 60 degrees it starts to deform. But for most of the things you can use it, or else you can use PETG. That's another kind of filament, and that one is more heat resistant, so it's better to print it it's harder. All those parts here of the printer, the orange parts, they are all printed in PETG. But PETG is more difficult to let it stick on the bed. I have to experiment with that. But I'm already very happy that this is printing. That's a new chapter, having a 3D printer. It's always the problem when you make things, how will you fit it into an enclosure? And if you need some brackets or some small pieces, you have to fiddle around with wood or with iron. And now you can make a 3D reprint of the components you need. But of course the problem is that you have to design your 3D parts before you can print them. And that's the difficult part. That's you can do it in Fusion 360, but that's paid, so you have to pay for that software, and it's probably the best. But there is also Blender. That's a free software, but it's a quite steep learning curve to work with Blender. But I'm busy with it, and yeah, for basic things it works well. I can already do some basic stuff, but if you see those parts here, oh, how they did that, that's amazing, the design. He finished, the 3D print finished. Incredible. In 23 minutes he printed this. Now we let it cool down. The nozzle is at 210 degrees Celsius. The heater element here in the nozzle is 210 degrees Celsius, and the bed is at 60 degrees Celsius. It depends of what kind of filaments you are printing, but this is very impressive. I will let it cool down, and then I will take it off and see how it feels, that piece of PLA. We'll take it off now. When you squeeze it a little bit, it should come off quite easy. And there you have it. It's very nice printed, huh? For first print, for the ones that are using also a Prusa printer, or for the ones that are getting started with the Prusa printer, my Z axis offset is at 1.050, and I must say it's good. For that, to set the correct Z axis offset during the setup, you can repeat the process several times until you find the right settings. And at the end, I came at -1050 millimeters. That's the distance of the nozzle of the printer until the print steel bed here, so that 1.050, and this is the result. It's quite flexible. That's the PLA, I think. It stays flexible a little bit with the PLA, but this is also very thin, so that's why it's flexible. But it's hard. You can't carve it with your nails. It's hard. So. Impressive. I'm looking forward to make things with this. Okay, guys, thank you for watching, and keep you posted on next projects. Thank you.